poor suckers, man, Freedy and Johnson. They got out of Stalag 17 all right, only not quite the way they wanted to go. Somebody in our outfit was tipping off the crowd sure enough. Only who was it? The Animal, or Harry, or Hoffy, or Price, or Blondie, or Goofy Joey, or Duke? It sure wasn't me. Maybe it was Sefton. Sergeant J.J. Sefton. I guess it's about time I told you a few more things about that Sefton guy. If I was anything of a writer, I'd send it into the Reader's Digest for one of those most unforgettable characters you've ever met. He was a big-time operator, always hustling, always scrounging. Take, for instance, the horse races. Every Saturday and Sunday, he'd put on horse races. He was the sole owner and operator of the Stalag 17 Turf Club. He was the presiding steward, the chief handicapper, the starter, the judge, the breeder, and his own bookie. He was the whole works, except that I was the stable boy for five smokes a day.
Give me equipoise, 10 on the nose.
10 on the nose. Come on, come on. 10 on Schnickelfritz.
Equipoise.
Schnickelfritz.
Equipoise.
Come on, boys, the horses are at the post.
Equipoise?
Equipoise.
10 on equipoise.
5 on Seabiscuit, and I'll pay you when the Red Cross parcels come
in. No credit.
Have a heart, Sefton.
Sorry, it's against the rules of the Racing Commission. Any more bets? Ready, Cookie?
Ready?
Let them go! And they're off and running at Stalag 17.
Come on, you beauty! Snickelfritz, you made me bet on equipoise.
I clocked him this morning. He was running like a doll.
You clocked him? Why don't I clock you?